So the benefit of data type in a column, let's go back over here. Now we'll try to identify simple type of data in this table. Now this is a department table, and guys, this is how the data modeling happens when your database architect, he speaks to the client. We try to understand the client requirement. Okay, you have a department table, you have an employees table, you have locations table, you have countries, you have regions, you have jobs table and job history. Perfect. These are the different types of tables that will be there inside the database. Now let us try to identify the different data types for the column names that we have. So guys, let us understand the employee ID. What do you think the employee ID, what type of data type should we use? Okay, great, number. Let me give you an example. What if my employee ID starts with AD2249? Then what do you think, what type of data type should I use? So now this one, this kind of discussion happens with your client at high level. You understand what exactly type of data is coming, and then you define the data types. Now the first name, the last name, everybody knows it has to be characters. The email ID will also be the character. Phone number, what do you think? And most of the people, they get wrong with the phone number. I'll tell you why. Because most of the countries will have something like this. They add the plus symbol and then they have 8888, something like this. I'm just coming up with the scenarios, guys. This again has to be discussed with the client to understand whether they'll have only the numbers or they can have the hyphens, spaces, plus. So if this is the case, then they have to go with the character data type. Hire date, come on guys, perfect. No one should get wrong onto this. Job ID, it again depends with the client whether it is a number. How about salary? It has to be numbers. I'll tell you why. Now let us assume someone is making $1,000. Now this guy, if you try to, you know, when you want to give hike to the employees, it has to be number, because you will be performing the arithmetic operations on a salary column so that the employee gets a hike, right? Now, if this is a character, then it will be hard for you to perform the arithmetic operations and you might not get the right result. So let's take you want to give, like 20% hike, something like this will work, right? Yeah, correct. So this way, if you store the data in numbers, you have some kind of functions that help you work on the data. If you store the data in character, it helps you, we have a lot of character functions that help you to work with the character data type. For date also, we have multiple functions. So we'll quickly run on to the other areas. Street address, what do you think? Okay, how about the postal code? City, state, country ID, right? On simple terms, this is how your data modeling is done at very high levels with your architecture and all. But now we will understand every component of this data model. You might be wondering, what are these symbols? We don't understand why this data is in a blue color. Why do we have star over here? Why do we have F written over there? And why do we have P? What is this? U and other stuff, right?